Okay, now let me just ask you this question before we go on a short break. Now, with the release of these 21 girls in the last few days, do you see this as any sort of victory? Any
Oh,
form of
yes,
victory?
indeed. Yes, indeed. It is. It is. Let me tell you, for 13 months, we've gone through much in this country. We have been called all sorts of names. We have been insulted. We are personally, I mean, there was a time in this country where we were practically in hiding. We were afraid we were going to be bombed either by the terrorists or something. Most times we were told so many things we have gone through. You're going to your home, you see cars trailing you, you have to now dodge and find a way. Our phones were hacked, our emails and all that. We knew we were practically seen as enemies of the state. So for us to see it just justifies all that we've been doing. It sort of like vindicates us to say that a lot of people say that the girls probably are dead. So today we have 21 of our Chibok girls being brought back home. And we know that there are more out there that need to come back home, 197 of them. And in all of this, we see it as a victory, not just for bring back our girls movement, but for the whole of Nigeria. Because this says to our citizens that wherever they are, the government will go after them and bring them back home. If anybody ever tries to take any of our citizens away, the Nigerian government will stand for its citizens. So as a Nigerian, you raise your head high up and say that my government will do something for me. And we can see the fact that for me, as some have said that, oh, the military, maybe they failed. They say, no, the military haven't failed. They have won. We have seen the military decimate Boko Haram. Once upon a time, the same Boko Haram arrogantly will tell us that they will never negotiate. They will go out there, they will get their members from whatever state, they mention state, and today we see them begging for that. So it is the good work of the military that have gone up to decimate them. We have always been ones who we support government, but would not allow them abdicate their responsibility. Even when government
I'm
didn't know
sorry,
it could,
I have to cut
we knew
you
it
now.
could.
I have to cut you now. We'll take a short break. Aisha Yusufu is still on the program Command Center. Like I said, you can follow us on Facebook at STV Command Center, on Twitter, Command Center 16. Stay tuned. Command Center is where we tell you the ongoing successes on the war against terror. It will give you a panorama.
In the face of an ongoing insurgency in the Northeast.
Welcome back. Our guest Aisha Yusufu, one of the founding members of the Bring Back Our Girls campaign group, is still on the program. Now, what was it like for the Bring Back Our Girls campaign group after you heard that the girls had been released to government?
Well, it was such a joyful moment, undiluted joy and happiness, knowing fully well that some of our Chibok girls are coming back, 21 at that. And finally, we will say the numbers that are remaining now less than 200. But later on in the day, when the pictures started coming out, it was such a very depressing moment, seeing our daughters, what they had become, and the state in which they were in. And at the same time, it was such an anxious moment, especially for parents whose children were not back. We still have 197 that are out there. But the release of 21 of our Chibok girls, I mean, it's victory for the nation. It's victory for us all.
Concerning the 30 long months, I've seen parents who attend your sit out. Every day the press comes, they are weeping. What has it been like in trying to assure them that something would be done even after 30 months?
Honestly, it's not been easy. There was a time when Esther Yakubu, for example, the one that her daughter was made to stand up and speak in one of the last videos that that was released by the terrorists, that's Dorcas Yakubu, who identified herself there as Maida. And, you know, on that same day when I saw her and I held her, I was just trying to console me. She said to me, Mamana, because she calls me Mamana, she said, you won't understand. And I said to her, of course, I won't understand. It's not easy. And even when the 21 were rescued and I reached out to her, like, how is it? how are you feeling? She said, well, we are good. We are happy for those that came back, and we are praying that our own are back. But as of that moment, she couldn't tell, they had not told the children. So it's such a traumatic experience. And even the other one, Mrs. Samuel, I had met her that same day. And, you know, I just held her, and she was like, oh, God, she just prays that her daughter will be amongst the ones that were brought back. And unfortunately, her daughter was not amongst the ones that came back. So it's not easy for the parents. And one of the things that the parents really find traumatic is the fact that people still don't believe that there was abduction. There was a mother, who, that's Mrs. Samuel, who said that whenever she hears people say that no abduction took place, that Chibok issue is a scam and all that, she asks herself, does that mean that her 18-year-old daughter never lived? Never came to this world. I mean, that's how pained they are. I mean, these are children, these are parents who send their children to school, spent all, some of them will tell you that they put their lives on hold to ensure that their children get their education so that they can go to university, be graduates, and take care of themselves and be, and you know, become, you know, amazing citizens in this country. And today what they are left with is just pictures and tears and anguish. And for them, you look at the father, how do they even send their children back to school? Every day their children go to school, they are thinking, will they come back home? Or will repeat of what happened before happen again?
Okay, now let's watch another video. Another video. Let's watch another.
Jamar, Allah, now guys, watch kids who are yes.
The Lord lift up the banner of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Peace that surpasses all understanding.
I have kuli kwa waya sabu kuli ya zauna. Mokta sere mche mungu. Ya ide sabu zauna. Musarabu shukabande.
Saw the picture, even here we are smiling. And I want to know the feeling for Bring Back Our Girls Group when they saw the reunion pictures.
Oh, indescribable. It's a moment that we cannot even describe. Even we as Unity Foundation, you know, we were jumping up and down like little children, like just being happy. For me personally, the most touching part of the whole pictures was seeing the girls with their Bibles. And for the first time in over 30 months, we were able to worship their God the way they wanted to worship their God. Nobody was taking that away. I'm somebody who is passionate. I'm a Muslim. And I would see myself and say, if anybody dares to take away my freedom to worship, or my freedom to wear the hijab, or my freedom to do so many things, my freedom to be able to look at a man and say, sorry, I can't shake you because you are not my mahram, I will feel devastated. And so for seeing them with their Bibles, you know, the Thanksgiving song, they were singing, they were dancing, for me, that was it. It just simply said, yes, our girls are back. Yes, though now they are out of physical captivity, mentally we need to still work on them. And you know, seeing that father carrying his daughter like a baby, there was one, the way he held his daughter, I was looking at her, it was as if the first time when they gave birth to her, probably the way he held her. And seeing the girl with the child was the same girl that was in the video. The video that was released by, one of the terrorists, in which a girl was made to stand up. You know, there was a girl with a child. That is the girl that is there. So it's just an amazing feeling that is indescribable. And so we're waiting to see that same feeling, being the parents, the remaining 197 of them, going through that and having that whole lot of excitement.
Now, finally, it is clear that government's efforts is already yielding results. Just a few days ago, we heard that about Nigerians should expect another tranche of about 80-something or 90-something girls do we see the group winding down its campaign and reducing the pressure on government?
No, definitely not. Not until each and every one of our daughters is accounted for. One thing, we have a slogan at Bring Back Our Girls movement that said, when would we stop? And we say, not until our girls are back and alive, not without our daughters. We still have 197 that are out there that need to be brought back home. We will still keep mounting that pressure because we know the Nigerian government can. Let people not forget, once upon a time, we live in this country where we saw the military, Boko Haram terrorists chasing away the military. And now what do you have today? We have our military well equipped, decimating Boko Haram. So we can, and we can rescue not only 197 of our Chibok girls, but all other abductees. And that's why they Bring Back Our Girls movement had the missing persons register to say every abductee must matter. Finally, let me just add this. We hold the president to his word where he said that the war, during his inaugural speech, that the war against Boko Haram will not be said to have been won without the rescue of our Chibok girls and all other abductees.
That is the much we can take now. It was a splendid time with Aisha Yusufu from the Bring Back Our Girls campaign group. We have come to the end of today's episode. Join us same time, same station next week. Do not forget to like our Facebook page, STV Command Center, and send us your comments and questions. You can also follow us on Twitter, at Command Center 16. I remain Amadin Uyi, your host on this program. Goodbye and have a splendid week. Command Center is where we tell you the ongoing successes on the war against terror. It will give you a panorama.
In the face of an ongoing insurgency in the Northeast.